It is Friday. I am Eric Holkren, and I have a confession. I am your top fan. Okay, by now you've probably seen the top fan badges on Facebook, and maybe you're either wondering, A, how do I turn them on, or B, if I have them on, what should I be doing with these guys? When I worked in radio, we had our own version of the Facebook top fan badge. It was called a P1, and a P1 was somebody who listened to your station more than others, and it gets its name back from when radios had a physical button. So the first button that they push, the P1. So on this particular radio, it would be this station right here would be the P1. Obviously, in an age where you can have 150 radio selections on your car dial, it doesn't really work as much these days, but that is one version of the top fan badge. If we go back to the days of MySpace, you had a top 8, and this was something that you rewarded to your social circle as who were the 8 most important people on that platform at that time. In this case, Facebook is giving that reward, giving you the top fan badge. But how do they figure that out? It's based on how much you engage with the page, how many things you like, how many things you share, how many things you comment, and that gets you into the pool, and then you get the top fan badge. But as marketers, what can we do with the top fan badge? But before we do that, let's do some math, right? Your Facebook page is not representative of your entire business. So if it's, let's say, 1 to 5% of your total business are the human beings on your Facebook page, your top fans are a percentage of the percentage of the percentage. So they're a tiny microcosm of human beings. So the first thing we're not going to do is make giant sweeping changes to our business model based on top fans. That's not what we're gonna do. However, the top fan badge is designed to be Pavlovian in nature. They like and share and comment more, so they get the badge, so they like and comment and share more, which means you easily could start shouting out to those top fans when they give you something that you find interesting. The other thing that you can do is you can target your organic posts just to your top fans. So if you've been hearing a lot about groups, but you don't really know what you're gonna do if you create a group within your page, this is a way to test for that. Start putting out some content that either only shows up for the top fans or only shows up for the top fans first, and then see which of that content those top fans like, and maybe build a group around that sort of content. And the third thing you could do is maybe send them something in the real world. If you can figure out who they actually are and get an address, you could reward those top fans by sending them some sort of swag. T-shirts, stickers, those sorts of things. As always, guys, have an awesome weekend. We'll talk next week. And if you need anything, it's Eric at mlive.com. It's crazy.